Hello, I'm Kim Allman. I've been doing caricatures for over 40 years. Started when I was 16. I was looking for a summer job and didn't want to flip hamburgers. And I happened to answer an ad in the local newspaper for the nearby theme park, Carowinds. Took my portfolio out there, showed them some of my drawings and portraits that I like to do, and they decided to hire me and run me through their little 3-week course to get me to draw the way they wanted me to draw. And that's what started me off on this career as a caricature. So I actually started out working at the theme park doing pastel portraits. But over the summer, the person who was doing most of the caricatures quit, and I took over that position. And well, as you say, the rest is history. So I spent about 4 summers working at the park, refining my ability, and the money I made helped me pay for, you know, the extra costs of going to college. And, you know, I pretty much had decided I was going to, you know, be a serious artist, and, you know, the caricature thing was just, you know, something to do as a sideline, but that's not quite the way it worked out. But I've had a really good time with it. Some of my influences, I was really influenced in my teens by a lot of the Mad Magazine comic artists like Jack Davis. I also was, for a teenager, I was really into politics, and so I followed a lot of political cartoonists. And it also didn't hurt that my art teacher, who's one of my influences, my high school art teacher, Mr. Brigman, was good friends with Doug Marlette, who of course was a Pulitzer Prize winning political cartoonist and also had a regular daily comic strip called Kudzu. So I got to meet Doug Marlette on a number of occasions and got to show him my work, and you know, he sort of mentored me in some of my areas. I also knew Gene Payne, who was a political cartoonist for WSOC at Charlotte. And he too provided a lot of encouragements and influence to a young aspiring artist. I also liked the work of Oliphant, who was a noted political cartoonist for the Washington Post. In addition to that, I'm really into the science fiction and fantasy genres, so I was influenced a lot in some of my other illustration work by the likes of Frank Frazetta and H.R. Giger. I also loved comics and drawing comics, and that's one of the things I really wanted to do in life, was be a comic book artist. That's something I haven't quite done, though in this day and time with the internet, I've been working on a regular webcomic and trying to promote that. My claims to fame. I don't know if I have any really strong claims to fame. I feel like I've brought a lot of joy over the years to people doing caricatures and drawing them. I've taught people how to draw, and hopefully I've influenced some other young artist along the way, just as I was influenced by my senior artist at the time. I would like to be remembered for, well, I'd like to be remembered for being a good father, but as far as an artist is concerned, I want to leave some kind of a legacy, either through the storytelling I do with comics or with, you know, the people's personalities I've captured in caricature. I also like to do a lot of other art forms. I paint, I draw, I'm a musician. I'm also a writer, photographer. For me, art is like breathing. I have to do it. A day doesn't go by that I don't sketch or doodle something or get my camera out or sit down or play an instrument. It's part of my life.